into Mage Lock Druid. And we know Method Black, that's a composition that they've been looking to play. So maybe both teams sort of mind-gaming each other here in the opener.
Well, I mean, Zizon has Drainer. He was formerly playing with Pumpers, Nerdrage, and Cervantes. They actually beat Method Black in one of the cups in the spring season with that Warrior Death Knight. So if I'm Method Black, I'm probably thinking maybe something along those lines, some type of Warrior melee cleave. So the Windwalker Mage makes the most sense for them if they're anticipating that. Maybe Zizon anticipates this anticipation. Looks like Drainer is actually the target early on. We saw this in the open bracket from North America, Sidu versus Metaphors, and the Windwalker Mage teams actually just went after the healers most of the match. So I'm wondering if they are going to be able to find a kill there. Not, definitely not in the opening stages. Drainer easily survives the first attack.
Yeah, and it looks like, once again, Method Black with this Frost Mage Restoration Druid setup. Against this particular composition, you kind of have to play very defensive. And that's kind of been the playstyle of Frost Mage Restoration Druid right now. You just have to kind of sit back, wait until, you know, healing gets reduced by a little bit, because if they're in the midfield, Mercy, he's going to be able to do way too much damage on that Destruction Warlock, just teeing off with those Chaos Bolts. So Jamie on that Elemental Shaman, he's a little bit more durable. He's going to be the one that's going to be pushing in, looking to avoid damage, sort of soak up a lot of the aggression that Raikou and Waz are able to put up. But Waz, he doesn't really care. He's going to be plopping that Touch of Death, looking to get really aggressive, but really not able to get anything done with it.
Well-timed crowd control on Drainer during his innervate, so he doesn't get any free healing spells there due to the crowd control of Method Black, so potentially they could win on mana, but winning on mana against Warlock, Shaman, Druid, I don't know if that has really ever been a way to find victory in World of Warcraft arena history for over a decade, so I don't know if they can single-handedly rely on that. Big damage on to Waz in game number one, but not even getting a touch of karma. Chaz's Iron Bark appears to be more than enough for him to stay alive and push forward. But Zizon continue building a mana lead. Capacitator totem onto two members. No follow-up crowd control, though. Jamie's initiation is thwarted. Waz still trying to stay on target, but really not even denting Zizon. Leg sweep is when we usually expect a lot of damage onto Jamie, but so far, not much. And now Waz in a bit of trouble with a spell lock on Chaz. Zizon looks solid. Finally, some counter pressure here on Jamie, as he is low on health. Will he trade the Astral Shift, or is he just going to go down? Demonic Gateway across midfield, looking for some healing surges on himself, but Drainer still polymorphed. Catches one healing surge, catches another. Jamie holds on. Surprising that he's not running the Ghost Wolf build. You would usually see the Shaman players just run around in Ghost Wolf, healing themselves up with the Honor Talent Spectral Recovery. Jamie in that position actually chose to just hard cast healing surges, which is a lot more risky. Drainer is sitting far too much crowd control so far in these last couple of minutes, which is putting Jamie so far behind. That's why we see him at low health for so long. And actually, mana has evened out as a result. Method Black's crowd control, even the fight.
Yep, definitely Jamie in midfield still taking a little bit of burst damage. Mercy with good counter pressure here on Waz. Keep in mind, Waz, no touch of karma. He still has the diffuse magic. Good denial there of that Fist of Fury by Jamie, trading out that Thunderstorm as he gets interrupted. Raku doing a good job. And like you kind of said, Drainer in midfield is getting caught in way too much crowd control. This isn't normally what you would see from the Warlock Elemental Shaman Druid. The Druid is just normally able to avoid a lot of crowd control, sit very far away. Drainer, once again, repositioning, eats another polymorph here. And I feel like so much of this pressure coming in from Method Black is off the back of just big mistakes from Drainer.
Yeah, most certainly is. I don't know if we've seen him on Druid in some time. He's been playing that Mistweaver quite a lot, and obviously his Restoration Shaman, so perhaps he's just a little bit rusty on that Druid, and it's the reason why the mana is even close at this point in the fight. Drainer tries to set up some crowd control with a War Stomp, jumps into Feral Affinity form to dish out some damage. Waz exchanges cooldowns, but overlapped with Chaz. So 2-for-1 push from Zizon in that attempt. Creates an opportunity to kill Waz. They switch some damage over to Raikou, trying to put pressure into two locations. Catch Chaz off guard, maybe get an Ice Block. Raikou ducks for cover around the corner. Chaz is trying to reconvene by his side, but eats a full fear. Raikou is still alone, but they're going to go after Waz. Waz has no defense. Infernals have landed. Ice Block forced. Waz is in trouble. Chaz has to heal two members at the same time. Can he do it? He manages to stabilize Raikou, moves forward. Waz is starting to recover. Scary moment, but Chaz holds steadfast for now.
Yep, it looks like they are going to be able to hold on. Method Black does stay alive. Waz in a little bit of trouble. Going to be retreating behind the pillar. Infernals have landed by Mercy, but it looks like they were able to basically weather that storm. Raikou very overextended right now. Chaos Bolt might land. This could be the second Ice Block. Rake Stun coming in from Drainer. Chaz does manage to connect that precious Iron Bark, that very large defensive cooldown the Restoration Druid has available. And that should be enough to keep Raikou stable and hold on to that Ice Block. But still, big burst damage coming in from Jamie. The emerges on the Ice Bear, just so huge in this matchup. Normally, the Mage can rely on an Ice Barrier or a Blazing Barrier in order to keep himself alive and absorb a lot of that damage. But the Elemental Shaman, with his Purge, can remove that, and that, in fact, removes a lot of the defense that a Mage has available.
Ooh, Zizon making a swap, catching Chaz out in midfield and bursting him down. Big Earth Shocks, but Jamie's falling behind as well. Ooh, Mercer's actually running the Demonic Circle, portaling on top of Chaz, almost catching him off guard. Chaz, though, immediate reaction time, jumping away with that wild charge and recovers from a swap. Good reaction time on Chaz's part. Both druids out of mana at this point, with dampening now initiated. What are they going to do? Who's going to set up the drinks? Are they even going to bother? Maybe they just go for the kill. Chaz is interrupted. This could easily be the second ice block, but they go for the lightning lasso on Waz. I mean, they've been spreading the pressure onto all three members of Method Black, and it's been a huge amount of damage. Drainer once again gets caught in a polymorph, decides to use the Glider's Medallion on this one. There was no Touch of Death and no Icy Vein, so I would say that that was a mistake, but regardless, they do get Touch of Karma from Waz. Waz goes all in for a kill here with Fists of Fury flying on that Touch of Death. It could hit for a huge amount onto Jamie. Big hit. Jamie's low. He's under-responded in this position. I'm not sure if he makes it out alive. Drainer is still crowd-controlled. Astral Shift now as well, but on such low health, perhaps it's not enough. Drainer cycloned. Waz gets stunned away by Mercy. Mercy now going after Raikou, bursting him down, but Jamie is still low. Drainer's got no mana to recover. It's 8 seconds away from his Iron Bark. He's actually maybe just going to go into Cat Farm and try and kill Waz before Waz can kill Jamie. It's definitely going to be a race at this point. Neither druid is looking for a drink.
Chaz moving in, looking for more crowd control. Drainer completely tapped on mana. Chaz as well. It's a race to the finish at this point. Waz still taking a lot of pressure. There is no Touch of Karma available. And you can see Jamie, Mercy, they want to get aggressive. Raikou with good control, though. A lot of crowd control goes out. Jamie having to play a little bit defensive right now. Still trying to just kite away, keeping Waz in the open, allowing Mercy to get a lot of damage off. But Raikou has been doing such a good job controlling out Mercy in this matchup that the amount of Chaos Bolts he's really been able to get off has been limited. Jamie's still in a lot of trouble. Drainer trying to do whatever he can to keep him alive, but there's just no mana. Lightning Lasso on Waz. Either Jamie or Waz could easily fall at any moment. Where's the damage? Chaz trying to deny the kill with Ironbark. Waz charging in, trying to take down Jamie, but the Lava Burst is going to be a lot of damage onto Waz. He portals away, trying to keep himself alive. Jamie now caught into a frozen orb, has to kite out of it, wanting to avoid that Frost Mage damage. Now it's Jamie that's on the back foot.
They've got Stormkeeper and Feral Affinity. Waz is in trouble. Chaz is crowd controlled. He's got Touch of Karma. Likely has to exchange it. Jamie grounds an incoming Maledict Trinket, preventing its healing absorption effect for now, but a second is incoming. Jamie's so low on health. A third is incoming, but there are Chaos Bolts flying in from Mercy. Barely gets the Touch of Karma. Perhaps they crack it. I don't think they can afford to. Jamie is so low. Drainer just doesn't have mana. Innervate's available, but he gets crowd controlled. He has to Trinket. Now he's walking into a Cyclone potentially. Fully Cyclone. No defense for Drainer. As long as Waz can stay on target, Waz is going to be able to close this game out. Big damage, perfect crowd control, and definitely mistakes made on Drainer's parts. Mage and the Windwalker can benefit from stacked up members as well. So this map's a bit of a double-edged sword. I wouldn't necessarily say that it is advantageous for either side. Maybe it is on paper for Zizon, but if Drainer isn't able to avoid crowd control, then he's going to have a harder time and spend a lot more mana. So I would say a lot rides on, Zico said in the pre-analysis, Mercy's ability to break up crowd control from Raikou, and on Drainer's part as well, to avoid as much as he can.
Yeah, I think it's going to be really important in this matchup, but that really is your job on that Destruction Warlock. Raikou looking to get aggressive onto Jamie early on. Jamie playing a little bit more defensive in this matchup. He's just going to be looking to drag Waz away, whereas in the last game we saw him early on not be afraid to push in, looking to get aggressive on the enemy team of Method Black, but a little bit more of a defensive positioning. And maybe that is because he fell in that last game, but I feel like he needs to be that person that can move in, especially early on. I feel like it's going to be easy for Drainer to keep him alive, and that's where a lot of the pressure can come from.
All right, so Mercer has switched to the double Mortal Coil, so he could be a target without Demonic Circle to escape, but aggressively and also defensively gain some extra crowd control. Most importantly, a diminishing return that isn't too useful to the team of Zizon outside of Mortal Coil, so I think it is the right choice. We do see some decent damage on Raikou. Zizon mixing up their target selection here in game number two, trying to catch Chaz off guard, but he's more than ready, stabilizing Raikou immediately. Jamie still the target for Waz. Raikou building up maybe some icicles, actually just unloading them now onto Jamie. Drainer jumping in Feral Affinity. He's actually been attacking Raikou a lot in cat form, trying to add some pressure there. Infernal into triple cap totem. Beautiful stun lock combo.
Whoa!
That's going to net them a kill. beautifully done by Zizon, and of course...
Yeah, I mean, Rogue Mage Druid seems to be very powerful, well-rounded in this particular meta. Surprise. The Frostmage Restoration Druid, they just have so much defense, so much control of the matchup, especially when you pair it with an Assassination Rogue, who just brings so much consistent damage, as well as some utility that can sort of help those crowd control. Chain's just very, very strong. Zizon seems to actually have a composition that is decent, although Method Black, I think this comp is a little bit better for them. Zizon, with the Elemental Shaman, with the Destruction Warlock, anything could happen. I mean, you get one good Chaos Bolt with one good Earthshock, the game ends immediately. So look out for that, although I think Method Black on paper does have an edge.
The crowd control chain was dropped by Method Black. Drainer escapes without having to use any defensive cooldowns, which is important because Method Black hasn't committed any offensive cooldowns. Mercy leading the charge. You see that beautiful stun lock combo that we saw on Dalaran's sewers. See if Raikou ends up making the same mistake. Ursul's Vortex on his blink, beautifully placed by Drainer, but now Drainer is crowd controlled. With Polymorph, or Ring of Frost and Cyclone casted at the same time, there's no way to stop it. Jamie is alone and has to deal with Waz by himself. Mercy is trying to counter pressure, but Jamie gets Cycloned at low health on the Iron Bark. So limiting the heals on Jamie, although I think at this point Jamie should begin to stabilize. Chaz is now feared. Any Chaos Bolt from Mercy could be an Ice Block. He's not going for it, perhaps doesn't have the Soul Shards just yet. Jamie Kidney Shot. But a double Shadow Fury stalls Waz's pressure during this Vendetta. Jamie makes the equal exchange with his Astral Shift lined up with Vendetta, so those cooldowns are usually traded with each other as they are similar in terms of cooldown effectiveness and timers. Drainer constantly jumping into cat form, adding an extra stun to Chaz and extra damage on Raikou. Drainer's Feral Weaving, the cat weaving strategy. You see it in the MDI as well, the Restoration Druids adding damage to their pulls and in arena as well, very important. So look to see if Drainer is able to be in cat form and add some extra damage. Right now he's trying to stop Chaz from drinking and he has done so, but he left Jamie behind and has a lot to recover through.
I think that's one major difference between the spring season and the summer season. What we actually saw in the spring finals is pretty much every single Restoration Druid is going to be using that Feral Affinity. The extra utility you get from the stuns every time you re-stealth, as well as that extra damage, just seems too powerful. And I feel like that's one of the main things these teams have had to sort of adapt to. And I think one of the things that gave the North America team sort of an advantage at that spring finals is they were a little bit more practiced with that. But you can see here, these Restoration Druids seems like they are well practiced on that as well. And that extra damage can really spice things up in a matchup like this.
Nana is even, and that is not what you want as the Warlock Shaman Druid team. You want to be significantly ahead. And it will be difficult for either team to drink on hook point as it's such a small map. It's so easy to get to the other side and stop the other healer from drinking. Jamie hasn't been under too much pressure throughout this game and has been able to trade cooldowns effectively, so no real burst openings just yet for Method Black. Raikou on the back foot, Drainer cat weaving again, getting some damage over onto Waz, adding in some damage now onto Raikou. Chaz has to heal two members. Drainer is utilizing this Feral Affinity quite effectively. Mercy lands an interrupt on Chaz's Cyclone, putting him behind, but Raikou has Ice Barrier, absorbing the damage. He's line of sighting Jamie, waiting for his healer to be able to save him. Now they switch to Waz. They get a Trinket and a Cloak of Shadows, respecting the Dark Soul of Mercy. So equal trade there for Waz. It has been quite some time, I feel, that we've seen Method Black play the Rogue Mage. They're not looking, I wouldn't say that they're looking rusty at this point in the match, but perhaps they could have been able to execute more pressure earlier on. They go for the Vendetta play, but Ironbark's defense should be enough for Jamie to survive. He can commit the Astral Shift towards the end of the Ironbark if he chooses to, although they will be disjointed the next time they're available, so he would like to hold on to it. Waz using Evasion. Maybe he was anticipating a Bash there, and he wanted to try and avoid it, or just avoid some extra damage that Drainer is dishing out. The Evasion's basically only useful to stop Drainer. Nobody else in the team is going to be doing any sort of physical pressure. Cyclone on Chaz was nether warded by Mercy, so that was really well timed, and that puts Raikou behind and potentially into the first Ice Block. Big heal from Chaz denies it.
Yeah, looks like Raikou will be able to hold on. Mortal Coil into a Fear onto Chaz. Raikou still in a little bit of trouble. Looking to cast out some damage, get some counter pressure rolling, but Raikou, he has to be very careful. Gladiator Safeguard will proc. Maybe he knew he had that up, so he was able to sort of rely on that defense. Icy Veins gets pulled by Raikou. They're looking to get really aggressive. Interrupt on Jamie. Polymorph on Mercy. Cyclone on Drainer. Mercy, he trinkets out, trying to keep his team alive in this situation, but there just really wasn't that much damage from Raikou and Waz in that situation. They had the crowd control, but you need to have the damage available as well when you get that crowd control. Otherwise, you're sort of not getting too much done in a situation like that. Drainer's able to throw out the Iron Bark, completely recover Jamie, still has the Astral Shift. Things are actually looking really good for Zizon.
Yeah, Zizon, if they can just move on to match point here, that's scary for Method Black, and it means that they will lose the swing match advantage. So let's see what they can get done here. Raku down at half, likely going into the first ice block. He's relying on Iron Bark to be enough, and now they switch to Chaz. A big chunk of damage tossed out by Jamie there with that primal elemental charging around the battlefield. Jamie's going to be a devastating force. Do not want to reckon with. Drainer moves in, and that Feral Affinity gets a rake stun, then immediately pulls back, seeing that Chaz is across the field trying to drink. It's all about stopping the drinks on the Druid, so they're going to be chasing each other, keeping each other in combat, and inevitably, this game is going to come to a close on mana, I do believe, very soon, Van.
Yeah, I think it's inevitable at this point. Both Druids haven't really been able to sneak away for a drink. We're at 5% dampening. Both Druids around 15% mana. Jamie taking a little bit of pressure. Full blind on Drainer. He preemptively Iron Barked. That's a bit of a waste there by Waz, unfortunately. And you need to extend the crowd control chain. There's the full sap. Waz still getting aggressive. Cheap shot on Mercy. Jamie gates away. A beautiful gateway. Raku trying to follow it up, but they get the crowd control chain. Unfortunately, there's just no damage. Now Jamie's in a cyclone. Method Black, they had a 20-plus second crowd control chain, but unfortunately, Jamie just completely obliterated them and was able to gateway away and stay completely healthy.
All right, Waz and Raikou are pushing forward. Comet Storm Burst, full kidney shot. Jamie's locked down here in midfield. Does use the Glider's Medallion and drop a Grounding Totem to soak up that Glider's Maledict, but his healer is still Cyclone. His Warlock is Polymorphed. It's 3 versus 1. Jamie's in trouble. Vendetta is rolling. Astral Shift may not be enough as the Glider's Maledict is absorbing a lot of heals. Mercy saves the day with a Fear on Chaz and a double Mortal Coil onto both Raikou and Waz. Those are the types of crowd controls we want to see from the Warlock. Definitely a key play to keep Jamie alive in that position.
Yep, Raikou taking a little bit of pressure, but he still has both ice blocks. Kidney shot on Jamie. And this is what we've been talking about all day. The Assassination Rogue plus Dampening is a force to be reckoned with in these matchups. Jamie is able to hold on for a little bit early on, but later on in the game, the damage is just so overwhelming. Definitely has his work cut out for him. Lightning Lasso going to be used over onto Raikou. That gets interrupted there by Waz. Nicely done. Drainer moving in, trying to get the ice block from Raikou. But unfortunately, in the meantime, Chaz has been sitting down for a drink. Good denial there by Waz. And Chaz recovers so much of his mana. Raikou basically baiting there, staying on low health, running behind the pillar. They completely forgot about Chaz, and now Method Black in a commanding lead.
Yes, and it's very important for them to keep the swing match advantage should this go to a game five, so they can determine what composition and map location. If they lose here, they'll lose that advantage on a game five. They can't afford to lose this game, and that drink could just allow them to secure victory, but they need to survive this next wave, this next attack from Mercy. With Infernals entering the fray, his damage is going to be elevated. How many Chaos Bolts can he get? He's looking for Fear to bait interrupts. He baits Waz's, but now Raikou has polymorphed him. He needs out of this polymorph, but Drainer Cyclone, he's not able to. Drainer Trinkets to save Jamie, but he's left Mercy in a polymorph during his Infernals. He's not going to get any Chaos Bolts off. Now Frost Nova out of line of sight. Raikou totally shutting the Warlock down beautifully there. Waz gets set up on there, trying to get some damage out onto him, but Lightning Lasso didn't even look like it scratched his health. Instead, now switching maybe to Chaz. Now in a Mortal Coil, Mercy goes for a Chaos Bolt. Fake cast, trying to fake the kick. Fears is Waz. Counterspell from Raikou denies the Chaos Bolt. Chaz is in a safe location. Drainer is totally tapped, and Drainer at this point has to just throw caution to the wind and push for damage and find a kill. He's not going to be able to heal. He's fully blinded. There's no Gladiator's Medallion. He cannot get out of crowd control. Jamie is all alone. Mercy needs to save him. He's feared Raikou, but Waz gets the sap. Jamie's still in a tough position here. It's looking like Method Black are going to hold on their swing match advantage. Polymorph secured, and Jamie falls. Method Black take game three and advance to match point.
Excellent. For the Druid, whenever you land the CC chain, you can just immediately go and drink as the rest of Druid.
Yeah, talking about sort of swaps over onto Chaz, one thing we saw from Cloud9, which they did beautifully, we didn't really see from any other teams, was even though a player were playing a control setup like Mage Lock Druid, they still set up these big one-shots where they would have their Druid push in, they'd get a bash into an Infernal Stun, use all of their instant damage in a Mortal Coil to just try to just blow someone out of the water as quickly as possible. And I feel like with the Elemental Shaman, you could do that just as well as with the Frost Mage. If you can save up a bit, the big Earthshock, go in for, you know, a bash into an Infernal Stun into a Mortal Coil with the Earthshock, with the DR Lightning Lasso, you could definitely do devastating damage. So maybe that's an option for Zizon aggressively in this matchup if it's a play that we really want to make.
I will say, if they do employ that strategy, Ruins of Lordaeron would be a fitting final resting place, as it is a cemetery, and I didn't want to miss the opportunity.
Well, the thing is, if they use that strategy,
oh, they're not,
and
it's
they
not
win,
a fitting, okay.
Yeah.
Why did you call me out? I actually thought of that while I was halfway through that. Like, wait, that doesn't actually work, but then you
someone
actually
has
called
to
it
call
out.
You out.
And you called me out on. No one would have noticed. Raikou gets bursted down, and so far, Zizon's only victory is Raikou dying without blocking, so perhaps they're just trying to go after that as the main win condition. Every other target that they've gone through, they haven't really been able to get too much done. So, see what they can do here. Drainer gets swapped to, but he gets backed up by his Warlock Mercy. Beautifully timed fear there on Waz, preventing some damage on Drainer. So he charges over to Raikou to maybe bash him up. It seems like they're actually just training Drainer. So Method Black actually going after the healer. We were sort of speaking about Zizon doing it, but Method Black have decided to try and give it a poke as well.
Yeah, Rogue Mage. They're no strangers to going after healers as well. They can do big kidney shot setups. If Waz can get a Shadow Step into a kidney shot on Drainer when he's not in bear form, definitely a really vulnerable target like we see right now. There's the kidney shot onto Drainer. Frozen Orb gets dropped out. Chaz in a position to get the bash. Is Drainer going to be able to survive? Another cheap shot comes in. Gladiator Safeguard, but there is just so much damage for Method Black. Drainer barely holds on. Gets the Iron Bark. A nice Cyclone coming in from Chaz, denying some of that additional healing. Do they have the stun? Drainer has a little bit of time here, where he's off diminishing return for the stun, uses the gateway, gets away, and he does manage to escape. And he still has a bar skin and trinket, so he's not actually that vulnerable moving forward.
The gateway was very important there. Drainer wanted to use Overgrowth, but Raikou could use Kleptomania Spell Steal to remove all of its hots. So Drainer gateways in line of sights before using Overgrowth.
That cyclizes.
Jamie gets smoke bombed as Drainer repositioned so far away from the fight. That gets Astral Shift out of the way for the team of Method Black and potentially an opening to kill Jamie. Zizon on match point, and they would be knocked down to the lower bracket where they will have a second opportunity, but there's two Rogue Mages in the lower bracket. So if they can't beat Method Black's Rogue Mage, what hope do they really have in the lower bracket with two more down there? Perhaps they need to change their compositions. Drainer is still crowd controlled, but as the chain is dropped, is now finally able to connect an Iron Bark. Chaz has been getting a lot of very good Cyclones, I would say, in terms of timings, but Cyclone costs a lot of mana. Unless you actually get a kill with that timing, it's putting him behind on mana now.
Yeah, I also want to paint a picture. I mean, Zizon, they were the team that sent Chalky Milkman to the lower bracket, so they've already most likely dealt with the Rogue Mage in the tournament so far, so if they go down to the lower bracket, it's not completely hopeless for them, but Method Black really showing why they are a force to be reckoned with that Rogue Mage Restoration Druid setup. They've been doing great job in this matchup so far, aggressively really swapping around on different targets, keeping Drainer guessing. Does he have to worry about himself? Are they going to go after Jamie? And I think that sort of flexibility and versatility is what makes them such a great team. Raikou getting bursted down just a little bit. Drainer still looking to get really aggressive.
Oh!
Raikou! Cold snap. I believe that was actually
was
his cold snap.
I think it was interrupted on Frost.
So they got a 2-for-1 special on that ice block, and now Raikou is going to be very vulnerable moving forward. Waz also taking a little bit of burst damage.
All right. Zizon showing signs of life here, likely going to a game 5, but Method Black will get to decide the territory and know what composition is coming their way, so they should be able to deal with it perfectly, having held out on hook point with Chaz's drink. So they are getting decent pressure on Drainer, maybe trying to create some surprise there. Even though they're behind, they go for the all-in. They don't get the kill, but they get a lot of defensives. They're actually continuing the pursuit, trying to punish that Feral Affinity. And perhaps if Drainer is inexperienced, he could be caught off guard. You lose out on the Guardian Affinity's defense, that Frenzied Regeneration, the immediate recovery. So far, he's dealing with it quite well, though. Now stunning Chaz and preventing himself from being Cyclone, moving back into midfield, maybe tossing out some damage over onto Raikou. Raikou is going to be the kill target for basically the rest of the game, having two ice blocks out of the way. Although maybe Zizon aren't aware that both ice blocks are out of the way in that exchange. Likely they are, but there could be some potential for that mistake to be made. If we look at mana, Drainer is actually totally tapped, so they need to do something quick. It looks like they're tossing some damage at Chaz. Drainer's actually standing on the opposing team, Method Black. Infernals have landed. This would be the time for Mercy to get a kill. I'd almost like to just see him use Unending Resolve to make sure he isn't interrupted when he wants to cast Chaos Bolt. If he's able to get two in a row, there's almost no way that Raikou will survive. He gets a Shadow Fury, but now he's Polymorph. He needs out of these Polymorphs. Drainer dispels them. He gets out just in time to start casting Chaos Bolts. One flies towards Raikou. He gets Iron Bark, but Iron Bark won't last for the whole duration. Raikou blinks across the map, seeing that Chaz is crowd controlled. There's no reason to stay out in open field, so he's going to go on his own for a field trip. But now they actually switch to Chaz.
Whoa!
Beautifully set up there. They get his Gladiator's Medallion. Perhaps a close call if Mercy can get one more Chaos Bolt. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to. Chaz sneaks away. Zizon still keeping Method Black on their toes, but Drainer's mana is... It's very scary. They need to do something quick if they're not going to go for a drink, and it does look like Drainer just wants to get a kill. He doesn't even care that he's out of mana. He's just going to keep attacking.
Yeah, but it's really difficult. When a Frost Mage wants to survive, he can survive for a very long time. Raikou no longer going to be using his Shimmers aggressively. He's just going to be hightailing it out of there, using the Pillar, you know, this Tombstone, to his advantage to avoid a lot of the incoming damage Mercy and Jamie have available. In the meantime, Waz, he's going to be snaring up, kidney-shotting Jamie, making it difficult for him to actually get some significant damage rolling. But this is where I like that they actually swapped to Chaz. That Raikou's playing way too defensive in the matchup. This is when they can get aggressive on the healer. Chaz still in a little bit of trouble. Chaos Bolt lands. Is he going to be able to survive? Earthshock! Drainer, I believe, actually got the killing blow there. Really nicely done. And Zizon
get going on Chaz like we did in the previous match.
Well, in a rare occurrence, Twitch chat actually voted against Method Black at the start of this series. 60% of you thought that Zizon would win. I think 100% of you were right that it was going to be close. But Method Black looking to turn Ashermain's fall into Zizon's fall.
We'll have a good opportunity.
Map rename.
Method Black get crowd control first, but Drainer opens in a position where they can't immediately lock him down. So he is dealing with his first attack pretty easily. No cooldowns even required, although maybe they should have been committed. Big Soul to Forest Regrowth, enhancing the heal of that. And now Jamie stabilizes to start playing aggressive. Are they going to try and run down Chaz? They've got Waz feared. They go for Lightning Lasso on Raikou. Drainer repositions to get extra damage added in the fight. Mercy's Chaos Bolting Waz, so they're spreading their damage onto two members of the team. Chaz uses Innervate to make his healing free so that he can heal through that double-pronged attack for free. Drainer sits comfortably through a full blind, putting himself in a comfortable position moving forward. Drainer jumps in, but then catches a Polymorph. Raikou definitely catching him out of position. Now Jamie could be in trouble as a result of this mistake. Mercy defends him from Raikou, but Chaz and from Chaz, but they aren't able to stop the Polymorph. Both Chaz and Raikou surrounding Drainer. Jamie is still isolated. Demonic Gateway to safety across the midfield. Stunning Waz. Drainer reconvenes by his side. Still no major cooldowns forced from the side of Zizon as Method Black keep Icy Veins and Vendetta in their back pocket, looking for a push here on the Smoke Bomb to get Jamie's Gladiator's Medallion. They Cyclone the Iron Bark. They're in a solid position here to make a push with the Vendetta. Jamie will not be able to use Gladiator's Medallion to access that defensive cooldown. And in that 6-second window, Jamie could fall. So let's see if Method Black can set this up properly. Jamie, in the meantime, is counter-aggressing with Stormkeeper. Those are some pretty beefy lightning bolts tossed towards both Raikou and Waz. Lightning Lasso, Chaos Bolt. Good combo. Gets Polymorph right at the end of the Chaos Bolt. Denied during the stun lock. Well done by Raikou. It's really all about Method Black. This is the Kidney Shot. There's the Vendetta. They've comboed them together. Drainer has full heal over time effects, though, and seems to be dealing with it A-okay. This should have been a very scary moment for Zizon, but effectively nullified. Drainer's Tranquility and heal over time management more than enough to thwart it.
Yeah, I kind of want to just point out a kind of a cool play. Earlier on, we saw Drainer get caught into a full Polymorph, and it was actually off the back of Waz auto-attacking him. So Waz was attacking Drainer, and Raikou started Polymorphing him, and as soon as the Polymorph was about to land, Waz stopped attacking him. So Drainer didn't actually think the Polymorph was on him. So kind of an interesting setup there by Method Black. I don't know how intentional that was, but it ended up working out, getting them some crowd control. But now we find ourselves in a situation where cooldowns have essentially been reset. Both teams are basically full health. Raikou taking a little bit of damage, as well as Jamie. Now Jamie caught into a Cyclone, Polymorph and a Cyclone as well, now on a Mercy. Good triple crowd control coming in from Method Black. That was a really nice setup, forcing Drainer to use his trinket.
Drainer now with no Glare's Medallion. Jamie without his for some time and still low on health. Mana in favor of Method Black. So there's a slight lead now, I would say, at this point for Method Black to take game number 5 and advance in the upper bracket. And Zizon will have to battle it out for a second chance later in the day. Jamie trying to set up some burst, counterspelled by Raikou. Chaz is trying to drink. That could give their team an even further lead. And he is going to go back to full mana. The map pick playing favors for Method Black, but they do need to keep their eyes on Drainer. If he is able to slip away and drink, then it could even the odds. Jamie is still low on health. Iron Bark appears to be enough from Drainer. Now Drainer should move to drink while Iron Bark is active, but he is not. Chaz feared away. Waz the target. He expects damage, so he uses Feint to reduce it. They wait for the Feint to fade before going in. Drainer's crossing midfield, getting some extra damage onto Raikou and Waz. but Jamie can't support him. He's stun locked, unable to move. Chaz gets Ursula's Vortex into a triple Infernal. The Cap Totem, do they kill it off? They don't. Double stun there for Jamie, although he is still behind on health. Chaz's Iron Bark should be enough to recover the team. Cloak of Shadows exchanged as well for the Infernals. Waz fully respecting that Destruction Warlock burst. Now Linus sighting at the pillar, but Chaz is interrupted. There's no Cloak of Shadows on Waz. This is a bit troubling for Method Black. Chaz is falling behind. With no Iron Bark and no Cloak of Shadows to rely on, Waz is a target.
Yeah, definitely a little bit vulnerable here, but we don't normally see the Assassination Rogues fall in a matchup like this, especially one as experienced as Waz. But without the vantage of those Cloak of Shadows, he's going to have to play a little bit safer. Drainer throwing in a little bit of extra damage. Waz retreating with Chaz, trying to get healed up now that he's healthy. Going to be moving forward to continue the pressure over onto Jamie as Jamie gets out of line of sight. Nice lightning lasso there onto Waz. Immediate response by Chaz. He was a little bit scared in that moment, tossing out the Iron Bark to keep Waz alive and just completely ignore Waz at this point. They realize the kill potential is lost. Good plays by Zizon, forcing out defensive cooldowns.
Chaos Bolts from Mercy on Raikou. He's fully respecting those. Trades out Ice Block. They actually blind the Warlock. Waz did not trust Raikou, or maybe they were trying to say, hold the block, I'll blind instead. But either way, blind is now out of the way and an Ice Block out of the way. Zizon keep themselves in this game number five. Now with a good opportunity to actually find victory against Method Black, which would be surprising, although Drainer in the past has been a thorn in Method Black's side, having taken one of the Spring Cups away from them.
Ooh, Drainer getting Evan bolted, does manage to get out of line of sight. And this matchup has ramifications on the entire tournament. If Zizon has actually figured out a composition that beats Rogue Mage Druid, most of the teams in this tournament rely on that setup. And I feel like this Destruction Warlock, Elemental Shaman, Restoration Druid is just so well-rounded. It could be the new composition to beat if they can take down Method Black here in this series.
All right, Waz is attacking Drainer. Drainer doesn't even seem to care, just shakes it off and starts marching towards Raikou in cat form. Drainer wants to get the second block. He's thirsty for victory. Jamie's lobbing out Lava Burst. Raikou and Chaz are pinned down at the pillar. Mana's not looking too good, even though Chaz was able to get a drink. Drainer gets stunned, but he goes into bear form, anticipating the attack. His bear form makes him a lot more durable, but without the Guardian Affinity, it's not guaranteed survival. He tries to jump away, but gets Ursula's Vortex back into the fray. Fighter's Maledict absorbing some heals.
Uh-oh.
Waz, Raikou, and Chaz collide onto Drainer. He's wrapping around the corner to survive. He needs some backup. Raikou gets speared away by Mercy. Now they're going after Waz with a Chaos Bolt. Dips him fairly low on health. Mana basically even at this point, and still anyone's match.
Yeah, Drainer activating the Innervate to top himself off, get some heals rolling onto Jamie. He's a little bit behind in that situation. There's the Kidney Shot Smoke Bomb. Jamie has Trinket and Astral Shift. Does manage to stay alive. A little bit of greedy plays there, but ultimately holds on to all his defensive cooldowns. Drainer in the fight right now, trying to throw in some additional damage as Chaz is caught into a fear. This could be the second Ice Block potentially from Raikou as he blinks away, trying to avoid a little bit of damage, but Jamie and Mercy, they're in hot pursuit. Lightning Lasso gets traded out. Watts is an immediate interrupt, saving Raikou in that situation. Really good backup.
Jamie's stunned up, but Drainer already at Iron Bark rolling. Drainer's just going to attack Raikou, putting on some pressure, but now caught in a polymorph. Big mistake here by Drainer. Potentially game-losing mistake. Mercy's trying to cover for it with his Infernals. Perhaps he can carry in this position. Interrupted on Shadow Fury, but now available to Chaos Bolt. One Chaos Bolt needs another. Raikou blinks out of line of sight. He's not going to find it. Jamie is so far behind as a result of Drainer's mistake, and I'm not sure if he's going to recover. It's do or die. Drainer has no mana left, but Raikou has Icebox to survive. Jamie is cycloned at low health. This is snowballing out of control. Method Black are in a dominant position. This game could end at any moment for them. Full blind secured.
That's
and that
it.
Is easily the kill. Method Black take game five in advance.
GG. Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.